mercy on our souls. Still we stay away from the major sins. Ignore the whispers of the Shehatins. Oh Lord, have mercy on our souls. Oh Lord, have mercy on our souls.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ومن اقتفى أثرهم إلى يوم الدين. All the praise and all the glory is due to Allah, and I bear witness that there is no God but Allah and that Muhammad is his last prophet and messenger. Today's session we are talking about a very important station of the heart. The heart, as I mentioned before, should pass through different stations in its straight way to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that starts with this dunya and ends with the Jannah, inshallah. Talking about the straight path, I would like actually to recall a story about some righteous people came to Al-Hasan Al-Basri. And Al-Hasan Al-Basri is a follower of the second generation right after the Sahaba. So he saw the Sahaba, but he did not witness the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They came to him and said, "Ya Hasan," when they reported some stories about the Sahaba and how they were very active and energetic and worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and doing their best to attain the Jannah. As you know, the Sahaba are the best, the elite of all nations. So the men said to Al-Hasan, "We saw that the companions have already taken up the Jannah, and they have already advanced us riding fast horses. And we are coming back in the end of the line riding weak donkeys." The Sahaba having horses, and we had weak donkeys that cannot go faster like them. So what Al-Hasan al-Basri said? He said, "As long as you are on the track, you will reach inshallah." So this is a message for everybody. As long as you are on the track, you will definitely inshallah reach the mercy of Allah. This is very important. So in today's topic, we are talking about khushu'. It is translated as attentiveness of the mind or presence of the mind. But actually, I need to refer to the literal Arabic meaning of the word khushu'. What is khushu'? Khasha'a. When you say the word khasha'a in Arabic, it means that he kept motionless, doesn't move, stable, calm, peaceful, doesn't move here and there, doesn't blink an eye. A state of calmness and tranquility and peace. This khushu', it's also accompanied by lowering the gaze, looking down, exactly like when you are actually approaching a king and you are entering into his palace. So the king is receiving you by himself. So in front of the king, you cannot look and gaze at his face. You cannot walk quickly. You cannot turn right and left, you just concentrate. You look on the ground, you have full politeness, attentiveness to whatever the king says. You are very smart, you respond quickly to what the king asks you to do. So this is a state of khushu', which is supposed to be present in the prayer of every single Muslim. This is the reason that there are a lot of distractions of khushu'. Like, for example, when a person prays and is praying very fast, quickly, another person is actually turning his hatching here and there. He's moving his hands. He's looking to the sky, to the ceiling. He's looking to people moving here and around. And when he is making ruku, he's not properly bowed down. He's making it very fast. So the Prophet ﷺ, according to the authentic hadith, when a man entered into the masjid, and he saw him praying, the man offered two raka'ats. So he came to the Prophet ﷺ to say salam to him. And the Prophet ﷺ said to him, "Return back, because you have not already prayed." The man already prayed in front of the Prophet ﷺ. He says, ارجع فصلي فإنك لم تصلي. Return back to pray because you haven't prayed actually. So the man made the two raka'ats again and returned back to the Prophet ﷺ. And he said to him the same thing. Return back to pray because you haven't prayed already. And the man in the third time said, Wallahi, I don't know better than this, O Messenger of Allah. So teach me. So the Prophet ﷺ started to teach him how to properly offer the prayers. The Prophet ﷺ said to him, you should stand up, you make takbir, and then you calm down. Tuma'nina. This is called in Arabic, tuma'nina, utma'in. So be at rest, stable, peaceful, in tranquility. And then when you bow down, remain bowing down until you are completely stable, until every bone returns back to its proper position. And then when you stand up, do the same. When you are making a sujood, do the same. So the Prophet ﷺ taught him to do that in the whole of his prayer, to join khushu'. And khushu', actually, what we have talked about, this is just the bodily actions. This is not the essence of khushu'. Because what we have mentioned right now, these are the apparent features of khushu', which is when a person doesn't move and is stable and he concentrates in his prayer. The khushu' of al-qalb, khushu' of the heart, is totally different. Because khushu' of the heart is to calm down, to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to receive guidance, to receive contemplations in meanings being recited in front of your ears, in understanding the verses of the Qur'an, in understanding the meaning of tasbih, the meaning of bowing down, the meaning of prostrating yourself, the meaning of the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I talk to you to just give you an example of the greatness of Allah. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, having seen Jibreel except in two or three occasions, according to the different narrators. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw Jibreel once, saw Jibreel in his original state. Because Jibreel, when he was revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he appeared to him in the form of a man. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw him really in his original shape two or three times. One of those times that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wanted earnestly to see Jibreel. So Jibreel asked permission from Allah and he showed himself. So Jibreel actually just showed a wing, one wing to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and it filled the whole horizon. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was shocked and he was amazed. This is Jibreel? He asked him, what about Israfil? And Jibreel said, Israfil size compared to me is like a ring in a desert. So is Jibreel like a ring and it's like the desert? And he said, oh, what about the mighty carriers of the mighty throne of Allah? And he said, they are compared to Israfil like a ring in a desert. So each one of them, Israfil is like a ring and they are in a desert. And look at all of them. They are coming on the day of judgment in front of Allah, the Almighty, the Jabbar, shaking their knees. Their feet could not carry them in front of Allah. So how great Allah is. وَجَاءَ رَبُّكَ وَالْمَلَكُ صَفًّا صَفًّا. And your Lord has come. And the angels are lined up, rows after rows. صَفًّا صَفًّا. وَجِيءَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمْ. And the hellfire was brought in front of them. يَوْمَئِذٍ يَتَذَكَّرُ الْإِنسَانُ وَأَنَّا لَهُ الذِّكْرَى. On a day when a person remembers what he has already done, and there is no way of returning back. يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي قَدَّمْتُ لِحَيَاتِي. He says, I wish, I hope, I can't proceed something for my real life. The hereafter, this is the real life. Why I'm talking about this? This is to bring you back to how is the greatness of Allah. This is number one. Number two, to remember the hereafter when you are in your prayer, because this is one of the conditions of khushu'. The Prophet ﷺ said, صلي صلاة مودع. When you pray a farewell prayer in the sense that you don't have any hope in life. So you are making it perfectly because this is the last of your prayer. Imagine if a person, they are bringing him and they are saying that you are going to die after 5 minutes. What is he supposed to do? He is running after food and drink, and he is going to eat hamburger sandwich, and he is going to get the jewelry here and the account bank here and there. No, it takes more than 5 minutes anyhow. So he is going to concentrate how to economize those 5 minutes to the best of his ability to draw himself closer to Allah so it would benefit actually in the future. So at least he will make repentance. So this is the same for a farewell prayer. When a person actually approaches Allah in prayer and he thinks that this is the last 2 rak'ahs that he will make, he is going to make them in khushu', in attentiveness of the mind and presence, full understanding, full performance, and perfect action. In fact, some of us do not remember. Actually, my brothers and sisters, al-khushu' is the first thing to be taken out from our lives. According to the authentic hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, I will actually narrate and talk to you about after having this short break, and then we will return back, inshallah.
Distinguished world-famous orator who dedicated their lives to convey the message of peace came together at one platform, the International Islamic Conference, with one vision, with one mission, peace mission.
I welcome all of you with Islamic greetings. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Peace Mission, next on Peace TV.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Back to khushu' or attentiveness or presence of mind in prayer. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, according to the authentic hadith, was sitting with his companions. And he said to them this word. He looked at the sky one day and said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala one day is going to raise up knowledge. And then Asim ibn Labid, one of the Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from the Ansar, said to him, O Messenger of Allah, is it right that Allah is going to raise up knowledge? And we already learn it, memorize the Quran, memorize the texts, and we let our children memorize that, and our wives. The Prophet ﷺ said, I thought you are the best one in knowledge. It means that he did not understand what the Prophet ﷺ said. He said, you don't look at the Christians and Jews. They had the Torah and the Injil in their hearts and in their breasts. They memorized that by heart. But knowledge was raised up. It means that action, they could not respond. And then the Prophet ﷺ said that knowledge will be raised up, not by like snatching, being snatched so the people will get up early in the morning and they will not have knowledge in their chests or their hearts. No, it will be raised up by the dis of the knowledgeable and the learned people and people of knowledge. And then afterwards, this Sahabi was meeting with Awf ibn Malik. And he started narrating for him a hadith, the same hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Auf was saying, yes, you said the truth. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the first thing that will be raised of knowledge is al-khushu', or the state of attentiveness in prayer. So the first thing that will be snatched from people in this life, will be taken away from them, is khushu', so they will find the masajid full of people praying in days and nights and taraweeh, alhamdulillah, musalli, namazis. They are making prayers everywhere. They are, alhamdulillah, their foreheads are actually erased and eroded because of making sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But on the other side, they are empty. They don't concentrate in what they pray. They don't understand the meaning of prayer. They don't have the spirit of prayer, which is khushu'. This is the status quo. When you look at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his sahaba, how did they lead their prayers? How the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recited the Quran? How the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam spent the night in reciting one ayah, an ayah in Surah Al-Ma'idah. إِن تُعَذِّبُهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ عِبَادُكَ وَإِن تَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ فَإِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. They are your slaves. If you have mercy on them, they are your slaves. And if you punish them, they are your slaves. This is the meaning of this verse that the Prophet ﷺ started reciting the whole night. The whole night and shedding tears. Umar ibn al-Khattab, may Allah be pleased with him, was making salah. And then he was reciting this ayah, or these ayat, these verses. وَالطُّور وَكِتَابٍ مَسْطُورٍ فِي رَقٍ مَنْشُورٍ وَالْبَيْتِ الْمَعْمُورِ وَالسَّقْفِ الْمَرْفُوعِ وَالْبَحْرِ الْمَسْجُورِ إِنَّ عَذَابَ رَبِّكَ لَوَاقِعٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took a number of oaths of significant things. And at the end of the oath, he says, إِنَّ عَذَابَ رَبِّكَ لَوَاقِعٌ. The punishment of your Lord is going to happen, is going to fall, is going to occur. And Umar ibn al-Khattab fell, and they started visiting him for 2 weeks. He cannot survive after just listening to verses, a few verses of the Quran. And Umar ibn al-Khattab, according to the narrator, they said that he had two rivers in his face, two cracks, two clefts in his face. Why? Because of shedding tears. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, when he was making prayers, they could not actually understand the verses that he recites because of the intensive khushu' that he has. كَانَ رَجُلًا أَسِيفًا. He is a man who always cries. And he do not listen to the ayats because of his crying all the time. As-Siddiq, Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him. The one, the companion of the cave, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. When we hear and we listen about the Sahaba, radiallahu ta'ala alayhim, they could achieve that type of khushu'. When you hear about Abbad ibn Bishr, who's Abbad ibn Bishr? Abbad ibn Bishr was actually guarding the Muslims in one of the frontiers. And then a man brought an arrow and he shot him with the arrow. And it was stabbed in his back. And he continued making prayers. And then the disbeliever came and he stabbed him with his own hands. And he did not leave prayer. And his companion, his friend, woke up. And he said, why you didn't awake me when it was stabbed in your back? He said, I was reciting a surah of the Quran. Wallahi, I swear by Allah that snatching my soul from my body is easier for me than leaving these verses that I was reciting. La ilaha illallah. Subhanallah. What type of prayer those people were making? What type of Quran those people were reciting? What type of souls those people used to have? They're very strong. They were very attentive to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in their prayers. Snatching his soul is easier in his eyes than leaving prayer. Subhanallah, this is amazing. We have a lot of stories about the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and their followers achieving one hadith. This is the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَجُعِلَتْ قُرَّةُ عَيْنِي فِي الصَّلَاةِ. And the coolness of my eyes were in prayers. The coolness of the eyes of the Prophet ﷺ was in the concentration of prayers. That's why he used to say to Bilal, أَرِحْنَا بِهَا يَا بِلَال. Relieve us. Relieve us by announcing prayer, يَا بِلَال, quickly. And now, subhanAllah, when we are involved in prayer, we say, relieve us from the prayer. Prophet ﷺ used to say, relieve us through prayer. And now we are saying, oh, relieve us of prayers. We don't like to make it perfectly. So this is the difference in the mean. And if you like to look at a successful man in this life and the hereafter, look at his prayers. If he is praying properly, punctually, making prayers on time, make sure that he is successful. The Prophet ﷺ said in the authentic hadith, which narrated on the authority of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, and he said when he was asked by him, Ayyul amali afdal, what is deeds are best in the sight of Allah? And he said, As-salatu ala waqtiha, praying on time, praying on time. And then he said, what is next? He says, fighting in the cause of Allah. And then he said, what is next? And he said, birrul walidain, being dutiful to your parents. So the Prophet ﷺ put prayers on the hierarchy, on the top pyramid of priorities. So we need to understand the significance of prayer. And this prayer is not achieved perfectly except through khushu'. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he talked about prayers in the Quran, when the Prophet ﷺ talked about it, it's not like performing prayers. It's called iqamatu salah. Iqama, what is the meaning of iqama in Arabic? Iqama means to establish perfect performance in perfect way. And this is the quality of the believers. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enumerated for us in Surah Al-Mu'minun, the main traits and qualities of the believers, what did he say? قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Successful are the believers. What is the first quality of the believers? What they do? Oh, they collect after money, they go after money, they run after business. Oh, they care about their children. Oh, they go in the cause of Allah. What they do? They give a charity. What they do? Oh, the first quality for them is الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. Those who are attaining the grade of khushu', khashi', attentive, present in their prayers. So they are achieving the highest degree of vigilance in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to show that they are His slaves. So if you would like to know a dedicated slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, look how he makes ablution wudu. Know how he makes prayers. How does he approach to prayer? What is the condition of his eyes in prayer? What is the condition of his heart when he's making prayers? How his limbs are actually humble? How he doesn't move here or there? He's just a very humble, submissive, shedding tears, attentively listening, understanding, responding. When an ayah says, make dua for Allah, he makes dua promptly. When an ayah asks them to seek forgiveness, he seeks after the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever is commanded, that's why it is a prayer which has an effect on his life. That's why it straightens his behavior. It showers not mercy inside the prayer, but the mercy extends to every single creation that he deals with. Even the animals, the cars, even people in the streets, you will find brilliance in his face, light in his face, light in his treatments of others, good behavior, how to treat people, and how to approach people because the prayer worked in him. Prayer through khushu' had a big influence in him. So it dynamically changed his behavior to the best. This is just a bird's eye view about khushu'. And we will continue inshallah in the next episode talking of how should we achieve khushu' in our prayer. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower all the mercy upon our hearts. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Stay away from the major sins. Ignore the whispers of the shayateens. Oh Lord, have mercy.